Hello, today is the last video lecture on VLSI testing and testability. Today we are going to finish the syllabus. And today's topic is the sixth part of BIST. In last tutorial, we studied following topics. We were discussing output response analyzer in that last technique, that is signature analysis. A signature is generated using an LFSR, and if there are m bits in the output sequence, we are going to generate a n bit signature where n will be smaller than m, and we compare the observed signature and expected signature, and error is indicated. If there is a mismatch in the signature, we took one example and we saw that the signature of faulty and fault free were different. However, one demerit is, since m is a large number, n is a smaller number. Take example m equal to 8, then 2 power 8 output sequence will be mapped to the only if n equal to 4, then 16 signature. So 256 output sequence mapped into 16 signature. So there are many output sequence which will have common signature. So fault will be masked in this case. The last one we discussed, multiple input shift register. It is similar to LFSR, but however we will have many inputs. In LFSR we will have only one input, but in multiple input shift register we will have n number of inputs. We will see its application today's lecture. And today we are going to study different example, two examples of BIST architecture. So far we discussed general structure of BIST architecture. We will take particular two example in this tutorial. In that, first one is built-in logic block observer. It is also called BILBO. So built-in logic block observer, and another one is self-testing using an MISR and parallel shift register sequence generator. These are the two architecture we are going to study here. So first one is built-in logic block observer. Here we will have n number of flip-flops, and each flip-flop will have one NOR gate and XOR and AND gate, and we will have one MUX at the beginning. So inputs are B1 and B2, the same B1 is applied here also, and this is the serial in output and it's a serial out output, and we have data here X1, X2 till XN. So we have four modes of operation here. So mode 1, in that B1 is 0 and B2 is 1. So what happens if B1 is 0, AND gate output will be 0, all AND gate output 0. And B2 is 1, since it is a NOR gate, any one of the input is high, output is 0. So all XOR essentially get what, 0 0. That means each D flip, each D input of each flip-flop will get 0 data. So what does it mean? So this mode is called reset. So all the flip-flops will be reset. Next one is mode 2, in that B1 is 1, B2 is 1. So B1 equal to 1 and B2 equal to 1, both are 1. So since B2 equal to 1, NOR gate output will be 0. So this is a don't care, this input will be don't care since B2 equal to 1. And B1 is 1 means all the AND gate are enabled. Now you can feed data X1 to Xn. So each flip-flop will get input from X1 to Xn. So it is nothing but a latch, parallel in, parallel output. X1, each flip-flop, D will get X1, this D1 will get X1, D2 will get X2, and similarly Dn will get Xn. It's a parallel in, parallel out. Third mode is both are 0. So B1 0 means all AND gates are disabled. So this XOR gate, one of the inputs of XOR gate will be 0. But since B2 equal to 0, now this is enabled, this NOR gate is enabled, and since b1 equal to 0 in this mux, s in is selected. So how this totally how it will look like? It will look like serial shift register, because b1 is 0, so s in is considered. Since b1 0, all AND gates are disabled. B2 equal to 0, so that means this NOR gate is enabled. It act like a serial shift register. You can feed data serial in, and you can observe output parallelly also, or S out also. And last one is B1 1 and B2 0. So B1 1, B2 0. So since B1 is 1, so what happens if B1 is 1, these AND gates are enabled, and B2 is 0 means all NOR gate also enabled. And since this mux B1 equal to 1, the input is nothing but the final output, S out is taken. So we can do two operation here. One is parallel signature analysis we can do. How it is parallel signature analysis? You take all the inputs. We have seen that MISR, where we can take n number of inputs, and it is XORed with one XOR here, second here, nth XOR will be here, one more. The final output is again XORed here. So parallel signature analysis can be done. It will receive n input and it will generate the signature. Parallel signature analysis can be done, or you can even generate a pseudo random sequence. For that, if you keep x1, x2, x3 all constant, if you set the constant weights, if you keep, then if you keep on applying clock pulses, what output you get, q1 to qn, is nothing but the random sequence, pseudo random sequence you will get. So it can be used as a signature analysis, or it can be used as a pseudo random sequence generator. We will see application of this particular block in the next slide. So here we want to test circuit block A and circuit block B. This application is called built-in digital circuit block observer, or BIDCO. It is built-in digital circuit observer, circuit block observer. So we would like to test circuit A and circuit B. So what we will do, we will have three bilbo. Bilbo means this is a typical architecture, bilbo. So bilbo 1 is placed here, after that circuit block A, bilbo 2, circuit block 3, and bilbo 3. So here what is how we can test to test a circuit, we need two blocks. One is test vector generator and another one is output response analyzer. So what we will do, first we will test circuit block A. In that, bilbo 1 is configured as pseudo random generator. So you will be taking in this, you will be taking output, all q1, q2, q3, all outputs you will be taking, and this b1 will be 1 and b2 will be 0, and it will generate all the test vector required to test this circuit block A. Next, bilbo 2 is same time bilbo 2 is configured as a parallel signature analysis. That also same mode, this one, this mode, but you have to keep weights constant. So bilbo 1 generate test vector, bilbo 2 produces parallel signature. So in that way we can test this circuit block here. Once we finish this circuit block serially, then we can go for another circuit block B. So in that, bilbo 2 is now configured as a pseudo random sequence generator. It is not MI, it is not parallel signature analysis, it is configured as pseudo random sequence generator. And bilbo 3 will be configured as parallel signature analysis. So like this we can have n number of blocks here. But only one thing is, you have to do it serially. Parallelly you can't test a circuit block and circuit block, because the bilbo 2, in the former it should be configured as a signature analysis, and second one it should be configured as a pseudo random test vector generator. So this is a typical example of bilbo architecture. Okay, so last one, second technique is, or second architecture is self-testing using MISR and parallel shift register sequence generator. So in that we will have two blocks, one is PRPG, another one is MISR. So this block will generate pseudo random sequences, let there be n number of output it will take. And MISR, it will take n inputs and it will generate a parallel signature. Now this technique is specially used for scan path. I think we have discussed a scan path in that all the flip-flops will be connected in serial so that you can test all the flip-flops. So now if at board level this each scan path can be, each path will be corresponding to a chips, but in chip level each scan path corresponds to a segment or block. So how we can test? First we will consider a board level, these are different chips. So PRPG, that is pseudo random pattern generate, will generate test vectors, let it be n number of output. So n number of scan paths or n number of chips we can verify. What is scan path? How many number of input? One input. And how many number output? One output. So each output is fed to the individual scan path or individual chip and it will generate n number of output, and you generate parallel signature and verify whether the circuit are correct or not. If it is a segment, then this each scan path corresponds to each block. So that PRPG input will be for all the blocks and outputs of all the blocks are used to generate parallel signature. What is the advantage here? In the scan path, in that we will give, we will apply only, you have seen that in the scan path only one input we have and one output we have. So if there are many number of chips, then we have to serially we can, but here in this case parallelly we can test all the chips using this technique. So this is the advantage and this will reduce us the test time. So this is about the BIST. So we have completed all the topics and I will be uploading two model question papers as tutorial 3 and tutorial 4 in the website. Please go through that. And if you have any doubt, you email, or once college starts, you can again discuss these topics. Thank you.